Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, welcome to Ikeda. Today we will see one of the most important part in a network function, which is called as poles and zeros of network function. Because without poles and zeros, function is not a good function, or it is very difficult to solve mathematically. It is not an interesting function. So let us see what is poles and zeros of a network function. In general, all the networks that we have seen till now have this particular format, which I have written here. N of s means you can see a network function, which is P of s upon Q of s. P of s is numerator polynomial, Q of s is denominator polynomial. And see, it has been written like this: a0 into s raised to n, and here it is b0 into s raised to m, and up to the constant term, the order of s is going to decrease. Here also it is going to decrease. Important thing is this a and b, they are real and positive coefficients. We have seen that for passive networks, that means for the parameters like inductor, capacitor and resistance, the networks which are called as passive network, always these coefficients are real and positive. This we have been seeing from Laplace, or even before Laplace, when we applied one dimensional or two dimensional differential equations. These a and b are real and positive coefficients. Now what we can do here, we can take this a and b common, here a common, here this b also common. Now what we can do this, suppose this p of s is 0, then it will have certain roots because it has a polynomial of this order, a particular order, suppose n order. So you can write this p of s as s minus z1 and now you can say that whenever this s takes values which are exactly equal to z1 or z2 or zn, this p of s will become 0. That means this numerator will become 0. So there are particular values of this s for which this numerator can be 0. Also, suppose we equate this q of s equal to 0 and then we write this as s minus p1, p for pole, s minus p2 up to, because this polynomial will have m roots because it has order m, the numerator polynomial will have n roots. So here also you can see that whenever this s takes values of equal to p1 or p2 or pm, this denominator will become 0. So these are the special cases where you have to consider your network function very properly. So whenever your numerator turns out to be 0, or those values of s or complex frequency s for which your numerator becomes 0 are called as zeros of network, because your network falls to 0. And for those values of s which you can see here, q of s there, for which this your q of s or denominator becomes 0, and when denominator becomes 0, your network function becomes infinite, and for that particular case it is called as poles. That means those values of s which are exactly equal to this p1, p2 and pm, because of which this q of s is going to be 0, those values of s are called as poles of this network. So this is very simple definition. Zeros means network function becomes 0. You have to see the numerator polynomial, and poles means your denominator polynomial, it will become 0. So I have a network function here which is given as n of s equal to s square into s plus 3 upon s plus 1 and whatever it is given. Now you can see here, whenever this s becomes 0, my network function will drop to 0. So here I have s square, means I have double 0. So at s equal to 0, I have a double 0. Also, s equal to minus 3, this minus 3 plus 3 will become 0, and again my network function will drop to 0. So 1 0 occurs at s equal to minus 3. Similarly, at s equal to minus 1, you can see if s is minus 1, minus 1 plus 1 will become 0, and this upon 0 will become infinity. So n of s will tend to infinity, and so you can say that pole occurs at s equal to minus 1. And similarly, here also you will have two more poles. So at s equal to, let us see, at s equal to minus 2, minus j1, and s equal to minus 2 plus j1, at both these values, this denominator will again become 0. So these are two more poles. So this one. So this is how we calculate zeros and poles of a network function, which I just explained. Now one thing is remaining. Whenever we say that this p of s is 0, we need to take this a0 outside, then only we can factorize it. That means if you take this step and if you solve it further, what I will do, I will take this a0 common, I will also take this b0 common, and remaining term which I can factorize as this or this, this p of s, this is p of s, which I can factorize as s minus z1, z2, only if I can take a0 and here b0 outside. So we'll write it. Now I'm going to take a0 common, and remaining terms I am directly writing in factorized form. And this factor a0 upon b0, we call it as h, that is called as scale factor. And this remaining term will be as it is. So we have covered this part also now. So what is the importance of a pole and zero? Suppose a network function doesn't have any pole or any zero. What happens? Then such network function becomes not that useful. In general, if a network function has some poles or zeros, it is practically usable. Otherwise, it will be a non-changing function, which is of hardly any use. So that is all about the introduction part of poles and zeros. So from this part, poles and zeros, we'll see some numericals which are on these poles and zeros, and then we'll see certain conditions for impedance function as well as transfer function. So thanks guys for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and please subscribe to Ikeda. Thank you.